Hey guys, I'm back. Hold on 1 second. Hold on, I'm talking to myself. No one's here. Hold on. Oh, hey, one person is here. Woo-hoo! So I just thought about this topic just because I was talking a little bit earlier about Dolly Parton and the winds and all that. I'm disappointed. I am so disappointed and come to the I don't listen to the radio in my hometown because they don't play women. I don't understand how we learn backwards. How do we go backwards? And if I don't confuse, I don't know who this one person is that's watching, but I can't see who it is. So if you can say something hello to this one viewer, off the cuff, Fluffy Hits Fireball is a good channel. She was hilarious. Go check it out. I'm gonna put I wish I had a YouTube. I will put it in here for you guys. And then out to show give me a shout out to her as well. Because, not only do I just want to talk about grief and being golden, I want to talk about entertainment too. So I feel like we have gone back in time in many ways, with the music industry. I don't know about other music industries because I don't listen to what work I do and no one at work really comes to music for me, so bad. But I just feel like they're not putting enough women on the radio anymore. And when I saw Dolly Parton do her interview with Robin Roberts, it was a great interview. And if you haven't seen it, I go check it out. I believe it's on Hulu. I don't know how long it'll be on Hulu for, but back then, men told women what to wear, how to do their makeup and hair, how to get, everything, what to sing, what to say. They were called girl singers or little darling. I mean, it just baffles me that we're going backwards. Going backwards, guys. And props to Reba and Dolly and for continuing the tradition and Taylor Lane for carrying on the Loretta Lynn's legacy and Trey Twitty carrying on Mr. Twitty's legacy. kudos to them. But what about Sarah Evans? What about Martina McBride? What about Tishina Wood? What about Leanne Rimes? But Leanne Rimes is more pop now than country. But Leanne Rimes, I mean, what about Winona Judd? The Judds, you know? Hey, the two viewers I have, what are your thoughts on this topic? I thought this CMA Awards, I thought that the opening was done really well. I did not watch the whole thing. I'm not into award shows, but I'm just not, because they're not country anymore. They're not. It's all pop country. That's it. I mean, you have Josh Turner, Jason Scott and McCartney. That's country. You have George Strait, Alan Jackson. I mean, those are living legends. But why aren't they being played on the radio? That's my question. Why? Do you guys know why? I just thought this was a nice thing to do because of the topic. Like, I love my all-time favorite is Loretta Lynn. Funny story. Story time. You all know that my mom died about 5 years in March. No. 4 years in March. Last year, I was in such a deep depression. And I was just playing around on YouTube. I was just looking stuff up, watching videos, and even Facebook Live, you know, watching stuff on Facebook just to pass the time. I found this woman who had just lost her mom that night. I found out that her mom had died in her sleep. You guys, she was crying on Facebook Live. I had no idea who she was related to, what her background was. That I didn't know that she lived, and I'm not going to say where she lived. Well, I didn't know she lived in the same town as my grandparents, my grandfather, and my grandmother in Tennessee until about 5 months or so after following her on Facebook and Instagram. Dude, Lynn is Loretta Lynn's granddaughter. I had no idea. No freaking idea. I have She's a wonderful person. She's open, honest, has a good heart. I mean, she'll tell you what she's just like her mama. She'll tell you what she's been working. But even she's just having a hard time getting started. I mean, yeah, she's going on tour, that's going great. You know, I got her song, I'm in a video. I think I can post that to YouTube because I don't want to get copyrighted. Because they work so hard on that, and I'm not sure if everyone who's in it wants it. But anyways, so why am I not getting news? So you guys, you know, you can DM me on Instagram. My Instagram is at Amanda Ruth. I'm sure you don't try to find me on Facebook. I don't have a public Facebook. Just for the fact of the field that I was in and the field that my mom was in. My mom taught special ed for over 30 years, and when I was practicing social work, I had a lot of students end up becoming my clients. So I had to put my Facebook to private for that reason. Then you can also find me on Twitter. It's also my Twitter handle is Amanda Ruth MC34. So yeah. So you guys can follow me there. I don't know what. So yeah, so I'm just really disappointed in the DJs not playing the music. I mean, Reba has an awesome CD out now that she did. And that one of the songs on there is Tell Me Why Not kind of tune. Tell Me Why Not was good. If you guys get a chance, check them out. Sadly, Tony is no longer with us, but her music still lives on. I believe her daughter, Georgette Jones, is also recording and putting out music. That's the daughter that she had with the legendary George Jones. So, I think that's what's going on. And Amanda Barnett, she's amazing. Her voice is impeccable. I'm gonna get my comments to come on. Did you all see the movie about Catherine Amoretta? That was amazing. Amazing movie. They showed that's what country music is. Women helping other women to achieve their goals. And I think that should be something that we all I think that's something that we all could use in our life, the friendship like that, where they're there for one another. I do have a bestie that I know that she's always there if needed. She's got her own mom, she's got her own kids. That's not sure if I'm wrong. No one's chatting. What the hell, man? Oh. I have the Honky Tonk Girl collection box set from Borderland, and when I was a teenager and I was home alone, you know, because my brother could drive, my mom went out, I was just home alone by myself. I was just sitting and listening to it, and I even acted out some of the songs. Oh, it was so funny. I don't have a voice. I can't. Wish I could. Just don't have it. I'm just trying to. Who is this one person that's watching? Can you please say hi? Because I feel like I'm boring you. Yeah, I'm not good. Do you guys know what ear tags are? I have those. Those are fun. I'm sure I no longer have them, but they were fun to have. We had like a Letterman one, a George Jones one. Oh, the first student we got, it was so funny. The very first student, when they first came out, we had this big stereo, kind of when you had the record player, the tape deck, the loudspeaker and all that, and then you could add in a CD player. So we got, like, my dad got like a 6-disc CD changer from my mom for Christmas. I think it was for Christmas. And then we also got her the Billy Ray Cyrus CD with It's a Broken Heart. I will never forget that. That was the first CD I remember that we owned. And I think I still have it somewhere. Maybe I don't. I think that got lost. But I do know I had the tape. Billy Ray Cyrus is a good one. But anything you guys want to talk about? Seriously, I feel like I'm doing this. I'm not going to do a Get Ready With Me video because I just hopped in the shower, washed my hair, brushed my teeth, get dressed, that's it. That's not, I can't wear makeup, so. I think I have a story time for you all. I think I'll do that one too. I have a funny story time about my former doctor. Is this still okay? Mm-hmm. Guys, oh, I want to go because I want to watch this live video that just popped up on my Instagram. But let me know in the comments down below. I want to get some, but right now I just kind of want to save up my money and do it this way. But I will do another stream, guys, later tonight. Maybe I'll cover I'll cover the heartstrings. No, I want to see that. The heartstrings on Netflix. I'll cover that. Because I think that was good. So I'm gonna go watch Without a Crystal Ball on Instagram. You guys, go check out her channel, Without a Crystal Ball. She's an amazing YouTuber. There's a lot of drama going down. So just go, if my subscribers, if you like the team, if you want to hear about anything, Toon Mom, Plaid Family, Duggars, Colts, anything of that sort, please go follow her. I reached out to her. She's an amazing lady. And I'm not trying to gain clout by mentioning her. I just want to say how much I'm grateful for her to give me the courage to start streaming. Although I work from 9 to 5:30, so my streams will probably be a little bit later during the day, and I'll probably only do like 1 or 2. I'm definitely gonna stream every day. I'll probably do 1 story time. And then I think what I'm gonna do also is I'm gonna cover a legendary artist. I think that's what I'm gonna do. And then we'll cover a legendary artist on a stream, and then I'll do like a story time and then about mind disorder and or grief at the same time. So let me know in the comments below if that's something that you would like to see. But yes, please go follow Without a Crystal Balls. She's an amazing YouTuber. And have a good day. Bye.